Writing Literature Review for Grounding Writer's Voice. Guys, it's really important to put your own voice in your literature review because we need to foreground our voice while exploring literature, and particularly for the sake of constructing literature review. And why this foregrounding of writer's voice is important? Because we are to assert our own position, our own voice in our thesis, right? So while writing down your literature review, you must show your own presence. And your own presence is basically your voice, right? So what is writer's voice? Writer's voice is basically, the establishment of your own authorial self. You are author and you are writing down something. So that is your position, which is supposed to be there while commenting on existing literature, right? So you are not actually presenting whatever is found. You are presenting while keeping up your own presence, while showing up your own presence. And that's really important from, researchers while doing their research literature review. There are two major ways to show your presence. Number one is taking control of the text. So you are controlling the text actually. Where to take the text, from where you are starting, why are you starting, and then you are commenting. Okay, so that's the step one. The second step is that making your own position clear. You are not only presenting whatever is available, but you are also presenting your own position. That do you agree with something which you are presenting, right? Or you disagree. And if you agree, why? What evidences are there? Or if you disagree, then what arguments are there? So that is actually about making your own position clear. So you are not only taking the control of the text, but you are also clarifying your own position as a researcher. So these are some two tips which are used for creating your authorial self. And then the writer's voice in the background is really important because that's the commentary which would relate the literature with your own topic, your own study. And then being critical in your writing is the way to show your presence, right? One tip is that you can start your paragraph or your section with unattributed assertion, right? So that unattributed assertion is basically your statement, which is basically your own statement, but then you start presenting and submitting other evidences in the favor of your, or maybe against the that point which you submitted, right? So you are actually the player who is taking the whole context along with you, right? So that's one tip. And you can also think about some other possibilities. In order to show your presence, you would be making explicit connections between citations, okay? Like you would be comparing and contrasting. You would be connecting various sources previously submitted and then the going on discussions, okay? So these are the points which you can do. And this compare and contrast between references is also really important. You would be summarizing, you would be evaluating, you would be applying some of the source materials for your study. And then the overall summary at the end of the section and then also at the end of the chapter would show your presence, right? So if the section is or there is interim conclusion, so that interim conclusion is also on the basis of your own presence, right? So when you are presenting the interim conclusion, you would say that it's now the time to conclude, right? So you are concluding. And then you would talk about the previously submitted information and that would show your presence. So this presence is really important. And you can also show your presence while using personal pronouns like I recommend this and that, right? Or the researchers recommend this and we are of the opinion, right? So these are the pronouns which you can use for showing your own presence and for foregrounding your voice. Then the choice of citation pattern is also to be decided because you are required to very formally document whatever information you are submitting in your literature review, okay? And then to evaluate the text, the summaries, the evaluative potential is also very, very important. And you should also be in a position to decide and to choose that what different reporting verbs are to be mentioned, right? So these are some of the tips which you would use in order to foreground your voice in your literature review.